Hi, this is Madeline from Sonic Bloom with a new episode of With a Little Help from Mix for Life. And this time we're going to have a look at three very cool and unique sequencers, all of them free, and they're all made by someone named, I'm just going to assume it comes from the German last name, Groß, as in big or tall, Groß 9978, and not Gross, but who knows. But anyways, let's have a look at these three devices. And so the first one, as we can see here, I've already prepared everything, is called Tree Seek, and it takes its name from this tree. The first step has one choice, the second two, and so on up to eight. And let's have a listen, and I put a marimba preset in. And here you can see we can set the root note and the scale. If it should be major, minor, and so on. And we can also say which octave it should be transposed to or not. And we've got the steps. So I could, for example, say like, okay, let's stick with... this. I'm gonna stay with A major. And then we can also go down in the steps. Now we've got 0 up to 16. And we can decide how fast it should run. Or 30 second notes. Then which direction it should be, forwards, backwards, or forwards and backwards. We can set the velocity, so we could make it louder as the output in the end. And the duration, which for this preset doesn't really matter. And then we can also use random. Here we can select how far in the, you know, note range the random should operate in. And we can decide if there should be continuous hits or not. So we can add little pauses, and we can rotate the tree as well. Let's make this a bit faster again. Go here. Right, so this is the first one. As you can see, you can get some pretty cool results with this. And let's skip to the second one. And the second one is called Slice Seek. This is actually meant to be put in front of a simpler device that has slicing activated, as we see here. I actually chose a vocal preset. Once you put it in front of the simpler, you press sync so that it gets the, you know, the amount of slices and the corresponding MIDI notes. You again can choose the direction and rate. So let's have a listen. So we could also make this go faster. And we can set a velocity range that it should randomly be in between the output. Same for the duration. So I could make this shorter as well, or longer. Then we've got three modes. So normal just runs through normally, random, or should it randomize anew every 2 or up to 16 bars. These are gates, so you can make sure all notes basically are generated or put through or if you would like to have some pauses in between. I'm gonna set this to 8 again, maybe. Or 16. And then we can also, it works best in beat, but you can also try like transients. Or region, or you can set something manually. With beat, you can also change the divisions to change the result. And in this case here, we've got like two that it runs through. So we've got this one as well. Make this faster as well, and shorter slices. So I actually really love this one because it gives you some amazing results with the right sample. You could use your own recordings of vocals or an instrument or a beat or whatever, and have it be sliced up and kind of like randomized and record the output, which I think is really cool to use. I'm definitely going to use this one. And last but not least, we've got Clip Seek, which is an audio effect, and it actually works with clips. So it's kind of like follow actions on steroids, you could say, because not only do you not have to put in all the details of what the follow actions in the clips should be, but you also get an extra pitch feature, which can be recorded so that you can make pitch changes happening. So let's just play this. So I can just go here and change the order of what should be played. Like this one does not seem to be playing at all, so you can decide if you want it to be in legato mode, so continuously playing back from the same position as the previous clip stopped. And you've got like different launch modes, just like in the follow actions as well, so I'm not going to go through what they mean. You can just try different things. Go back to trigger, and we've got the launch quantization. So you can either choose global or even none, or use any of the other ones, so just like you would know from life already. Then we've got the amount of steps. The maximum is 16, but of course you can go down all the way to 2 as well. And here we've got the rate, so we could also make it faster. Let's go back to a quarter note. And here we've got, this is a record button, and this is clear, so you can clear what you had recorded. This way you can change the pitch. So you basically get a pitch modulation included. So you can just go like, or just set it like this to one pitch so it doesn't change over time. But we can also like, I'm just gonna put it back in the middle here, and then you can just move it, and then it will just repeat this once you've stopped. This one's a bit annoying, so I'm going to clear this one. I'm just going to... No, that's that. So we can just play around with this as well a bit more. And go like, okay, so do like a quicker quantization for the launching. Like a longer one. And then change the rate up. Yeah, so these are the three devices, all of them free. All require Life 11 plus Max for Life though. Well, that's it for me today. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe if you found this useful. And see you next time. Bye.